Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Kimmy Vapes here. Excuse the wet hair. I just got out of the shower. I gotta get this video out to you guys. So today I've got a review on the eLeaf iJust 3. So let's have a vape, go down below, and see what comes with the eLeaf iJust 3. Okay, and here it is, the eLeaf iJust 3. Now, this product was sent to me for the purpose of this review by vapesourcing.com. Let's go ahead and take a look at the package. Here on the side, you'll see you have your scratch and check for authenticity. And if we flip it over to the back there, you'll see that you have the kit contents and the battery specifications. And inside the box here, you'll see it comes with the Elo Duro sub-ohm tank by eLeaf. And of course, then you have the battery mod here. You also have a spare glass tank. And if you take out the foam insert here, you'll have a box underneath. And you also get a spare coil head for the tank, spare O-rings and gaskets for the sub-ohm tank, a USB micro charging and update cable, the Elo Duro quick start manual, and the iJust 3 manual. Okay, let's go ahead and take a look at the tank first. Okay, so the Elo Duro sub-ohm tank is 25 millimeters at the base, has an 810 style drip tip. I think the acrylic that they're using on this is really beautiful. If you take it out, you'll see that it is a TFV8 style 810 drip tip. It does have the O-rings on the base of the drip tip and not on the inside. It has a slide open top fill. So right here where you see the little triangle carrot, you'll push on the top and it slides open. Something that's interesting about this top fill is the way the gasket is designed. You'll see here that this gasket actually has a seal here that when you push the tip of your e-liquid bottle or the glass dripper down, you'll see these two little flaps that open up on the gasket. And what this does is it prevents any type of leaking coming out of the top of your tank should the top cap gets slid back by accident when you're traveling, or if it's inside your pocket or purse, it'll prevent it from leaking on you. The bubble glass, which comes pre-installed on the tank, will hold 6.5 milliliters. It also comes with a TPD compliant 2 milliliter option. The coils that come with it are 0.2 ohm HWN net coil and 0.15 ohm multi-hole coil. And let me go ahead and show you those coils and what I'm talking about. To remove the vase, you'll just unscrew it counterclockwise. And to remove the coil, unscrew the coil counterclockwise. There is the coil. The coil head installed is the HWM 0.15 ohm, and the M is standing for multi-hole. So it may not show up on camera very well, but unlike actual mesh wire, this one is a solid sheet of metal that has then been hole punched for that mesh appearance, though it is different from mesh. And then of course the 0.2 ohm HWN net coil is the more mesh-like coil head that we typically see in mesh coils. Let's go ahead and install that coil head back in. And before we do that, let's go ahead and look at the base. As you can see, there's this very large rubber seal here. And that is what prevents your coil head from flooding down in there, as well as allows for sealing of your tank when it sits down in the base there. And one tip that I always suggest when you're putting in a new coil head, give it a half a turn or a quarter turn counterclockwise first so you can feel those threads seat into place, and then go ahead and turn it clockwise. And what that does is that just ensures that you're not cross-threading your coil head into the base. So once your coil head is securely installed, you'll want to go ahead and prime your coil head. So the e-liquid that I'll be using today to prime my coil head and fill my tank is the IVG Macaroon, which is a strawberries and cream macaroon vape. So the first thing I like to do is just dab a couple beads of e-liquid around the top of that coil on top of the cotton. And then here on the coil head, where you see these grooves, those are actually your juice flow slits. So you'll want to put a drop of e-liquid on each one of those little slits. Now, of course, doing this with a glass dripper will be a little more difficult because those slits are so small. So just try to get the e-liquid channeled in there the best you can. And if you're not able to due to the size of dripper that you have, just go ahead and do a second pass on the top of that cotton there and let it soak down into the cotton. You want to make sure that all of the cotton is fully saturated before firing a coil like that, or really any coil head. All right, so now that we're primed, we're ready to install the base back on. And now we can go ahead and fill our tank. So we'll just place the e-liquid bottle tip down in that grommet and squeeze. Okay, so our tank's all filled up. Go ahead and screw it down on the mod. So as you can see, the tank itself sits flush on the mod, and that is because this battery is 25 millimeters in diameter as well. The tank has a tri-airflow, so it has three airflow slots. And whatever you do to one of the airflow holes, it will adjust the other two airflow holes. And of course, you can close it all the way down. It does have a stopper. So the iJust 3 mod itself is a 3000 mAh internal battery tube. It has a max output of 80 watts. It does come with low voltage protection and short circuit protection. To turn on the mod, you'll simply five clicks to turn it on, and you'll see there is a light green backlight behind this button, which you'll see. When the light is green, it's charged 100 to 60%. When the light is orange, it's 59 to 30%. When the light is blue, it's 29 to 10%. And when the light is red, it's 9% or less. So this mod itself is very simple. It's literally a press and vape. There's no variable voltage, variable wattage, or anything like that. You do have a USB charger on the back, as well as a small hole there for ventilation. If you go ahead and look at the bottom there, you'll see that it almost resembles a mech mod, and that it looks like a button you can press, though there is no button there. It has a really nice etched design that goes all the way around the tube. And the tank itself has that same pattern design that you see on the tube and the bottom of the button, making it a really beautifully matched combo. So that really is all there is to the iJust 3. Let's go ahead and go back up top, and I'll give you my thoughts and opinions on it. Okay, that was an up and close look at the eLeaf iJust 3. So what are my thoughts? Well, I'm going to keep this short and simple for you guys. This is a great device. The only cons that I have for it is that the light behind the button isn't very bright. It's very hard to see and tell if you turned it on, as you saw in the up close. The light behind the button because there is no clear button or any type of clear gasket around the button, it's very difficult to see that button, especially in well-lighted conditions. So I wish that they would have either made the button clear or put a clear ring around the button so that we could see that light better. As for the tank, I really don't have any cons about it. I think they did a lot of great things with the tank. The tank itself, the fact that they put that little membrane on, oops, I just fired it. The fact that they put that little membrane on the gasket so is that if you accidentally leave the top cap open or for some reason it gets slid open, no e-liquid will spill out. Another thing that I really like is these coil heads. The e-Leaf did an amazing job with designing something new with coil heads. The multi-hole style coil head is what I have in here right now. It's a 0.15 ohm and it produces amazing flavor. However, there is one issue that I found with this one. As I close down the airflow, the flavor gets less, which is the opposite of what you usually expect when you close down the airflow and make it more restricted. Usually that bumps up your flavor and reduces the cloud production. On this one, that's not the case with the multi-hole coil. It seems to perform its best and produce the most flavor when all three airflow slots are wide open. So that's how I've been running it. And it is a cloud machine. For this device, only doing 80 watts, it produces a ton of vapor with a ton of airflow. Let me go ahead and show you. Just all the airflow you could ever want from a sub-ohm tank. I think this tank definitely beats out like the Baby Beast, the regular Beast, the TFE8, the TFE12. These new coil heads bring a ton of flavor. I've been vaping on it nonstop, chain vaping on it, and I've gotten no dry hits. These coils wick really well. I can see the air bubbles coming up in the tank, so I feel confident that the coil is wicking well by seeing those air bubbles. Just overall, in general, I'm really enjoying this tank. And back to the mod a little bit. Obviously, it is an 80 watt device, so there are some limitations. If you're somebody that likes a really super hot vape, like you vape at 110, 150 watts, you're not gonna get a super hot vape out of this just because its maximum output is 80 watts. So keep that in mind. However, like I said, it is warm, it's saturated. I have no problem with this device only doing 80 watts. And of course, because there are no variable wattage or variable voltage controls on here, how much voltage is going to the coil is going to be dependent on the coil that you have installed in the tank. Obviously, the higher the ohm coil, the lower the wattage that it's going to deliver to that coil. But on these, I feel it's getting really close to that 80 watts if it's not even going a little bit above 80 watts. If you're interested in the technical side of this device, DJ LSB Vapes has already put out his review on the iJust 3, where he does go over how much wattage the coils are receiving at different ohms resistance. So go check out his video if you like the more technical side. Also, just a quick note on the battery. It is only 3,000 mAh, so keep in mind that it's not going to be an all-day mod for you with the type of coil heads that they have in here. Being low ohm coil heads, it's gonna suck that battery pretty quickly, and you're gonna have to charge the device, if not once, twice throughout the day to keep vaping on it. So just keep that in mind. I love the design of it. The fact that it's a tube style, it gives that appearance of a mech mod. You can actually even hold it like a mech mod with your middle finger on the bottom and using your thumb to squeeze and fire the device. Or you can just hold it like a pen style device and finger fire it. And that's all I have to say about the device. It comes in a large variety of colors. You have purple, you have black, you have stainless steel, you have blue. I believe there's even a red, and there's also a rainbow. eLeaf did a phenomenal job with the iJust 3. Thank you guys for watching. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up. If you're not already and like what I do here, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. And if you are subscribed, please don't forget to hit the bell notification icon so you get notified the next time I upload a video. Until next time, you guys, bye-bye.